says it's the end of time, and the Mississippi River, she's a gold grind. The interest is up and the stock market's down, and you're only getting mugged if you go downtown. I live back in the woods, you see, my woman and the kids and the dogs and me. I got a shotgun, a rifle, and a four-wheel drive, and a country boy can survive. Country folks can survive. I can plow a field all day long. I can catch catfish from dusk till dawn.
I've always been into mechanics, working on cars and trucks, and I like working with my hands and getting dirty, and it's fun.
There's this idea out there that it's just turning wrenches and it's all grease work. And with these tractors today, that's not the case.
I was surprised at how complicated the electronic systems on these tractors are, how many computers they have on board. We learn everything from the electronics, the hydraulics, air conditioning, engines, and computers.
A tractor like this, it's got five or six, seven controllers all communicating back and forth, and it's a huge challenge. If you go into this line, you're pretty well going to be guaranteed a position for life. The need is that great.
If you know what you're doing, you can tackle just about anything, and the tools make everything real easy. You know, you don't need to be real strong or real big. Everybody, man or woman, you know, old or young, can get into this and really enjoy it.
I'm interested in the environment, and I'm interested in learning about the different sources of energy and then also ways to conserve energy.
Currently, I'm working for a pretty large institution. It's a medical center. We have a tremendous amount of energy that we use every day. Being green is not just a trend, but I see it more as a movement of how we're changing our thinking and lifestyle.
The idea is to look at over the lifespan of the building or the renovation to consume less resources in building it, and then also to consume less resources in operating the building.
And that's what I like about it, is just having that daily challenge of looking for different ways to reduce our consumption.
Before you even hit a job site, you're supposed to know all the documents, the drawings, and the specs.
Construction management is really about managing the time, the cost, and the quality of a project. You have to make sure that your project is coming in on time. You have to make sure that the project is built to the specifications that are outlined.
You could have as many as 7, 8, maybe even more trades simultaneously working in the same space.
You know, that's really why you have to know a lot about everything, is because every single one of the trades that is involved in building this building comes to you to look for answers. I usually do well in pressure situations. I wouldn't say that I'm a drilling junkie or anything, but it is nice to know that, you know, what you're doing is important. I take pride in knowing that, you know, that's a building that I was a part of.
Ever since maybe middle school or even elementary school, I wanted to do something that had to do with movies. I'm currently working at a post house that features commercials.
I do like to be able to tell a story. For me, post is really my favorite because you get the most time to sit down and really experiment with the material you've been given. You can look at the story, you can play around with the pacing.
We got to learn all about what parts the camera has, how they work. One day you might be working a PA job, while another day you're going to be helping out with editing. I've done DPing or cinematography before. You get to really boss people around, tell them where the lights are. You have full control of what the vision is.
It's not as difficult to get into the industry as some people make it out to be. It's so much fun.
It is.
It's really rewarding.
Business. I was always so undecided about what specific field I wanted to go into because I have interest in so much.
It made me a well-rounded individual in business to be able to learn all the other disciplines that were required of my major.
Such a variety of classes that I'm taking with such wonderful instructors because it gives you so much versatility and opportunity to go into any particular field that I want. It really is like a gateway to opening all sorts of opportunities and doors for me.
A strong work ethic is required of individuals in business because you have timelines, you have deadlines, you have goals that you need to achieve.
But everything that I'm learning is being applied to the actual real life situations.
So when you graduate, your employers are going to be looking for those skills.
It was a turning point when I realized that it can really lead to anything else I want to do. I know that I made the right selection and right path in selecting the business aspect.
Money. 9/11 really sparked that desire to do something to help people out.
It is about people's lives. You have to have compassion. You have to be able to quickly pull out of your memory bank all your training.
You learn all kinds of skills. You learn things from IVs to your different medications. They run you through a lot of scenarios, but I think a lot of it comes along with the hands-on portion with clinicals and ride-alongs. You have to be able to deal with a highly stressful situation.
This is something that you have to really, really dedicate yourself to. And you have to be a people person.
I like being right there in emergencies, first responder. I like being where the real action is.
This is something that I can see myself now doing for the rest of my life.
Big field. You get to see a lot of people, you get to meet a lot of people. Pretty social, so I need that.
We are trying to understand the process. We learn like every function within the logistics supply chain, like just from beginning to finish.
So it involves manufacturing and production facilities and distribution centers and warehouses all the way to the customer.
It's basically the moving of product from one place to the next.
An item can be looked up via the UPC number.
Those barcodes are extremely important. It basically tells you where the items is at.
I think that it saves a lot of time.
I think it's a growing industry, especially in Texas here. Very centrally located. I want a permanent career, and I want to be industry that's growing.
Now is culinary. Everything is, you know, Food Network, and the restaurants that are opening up are high quality.
You learn about all your products, how to use them, how to cook them. It's not just following your recipes, following your instincts, your imagination.
You really have to be in the mindset of becoming a professional. You have to be a team player.
You have to be very responsible. You have to have discipline.
You want to have that talent to where you have your own creativity. It would definitely get you out there to where you can become that executive chef. You can become a restaurant manager. You can run a multi-million-dollar facility. If you have that degree and knowledge, you can definitely be very successful.
learn about their development stages, but then you also learn how to keep their attention, how to teach them without them thinking, I'm learning. You gotta make it fun.
Patience, laughter, enjoyment, fun, making things fun.
In order to keep your classroom and everything running smoothly, you have to be flexible and very patient.
And if you hear a holler that's not familiar, you know that's a holler for help. So you do have to be on your toes, actually on your tippy toes.
Or they figured something out and they use the words, I did it. You know, that's just great because they know they've done it and everyone's proud of them. So it's great to see them grow that way and use their words and get excited. And of course, you know, we do a happy dance and take pictures.
It's just a joy to see children learn, a joy to see children grow.
I've been cutting my dad's hair since I was 9 years old. And I wanted to do something different. And I wanted to do something that I was going to be passionate about.
We cut hair, we color, we do everything. Manicures, pedicures, facials. They train you to cut in your first semester, and then by second semester, you're in the salon and you're actually working on clients.
And that's a great advantage because you're working with real people. You're cutting hair.
I love people. I love to talk. And I love to make people feel good. That's really important. Social skills, because like we said, you work hands-on with people all day, every day.
It's amazing. The whole program, the staff, the teachers.
The instructors here are fabulous. I think they're like the best when it comes to preparing you for the real world.
I love doing hair. That's my passion. And when you see the final product, it's rewarding.
In the third grade, and an officer came to my classroom. I saw him and I knew instantly that that's what I wanted.
Everything that you need to know out there in the law enforcement field, you can learn it here.
It's about 6 months long, so you have to learn it and understand it.
The simulator for me was awesome. It just gives you so many different types of scenarios where you have to make that split decision in order to decide what you're going to do.
The instructors are great about opening up our minds and getting us to think outside the box.
They also have a lot of knowledge, experience within the criminal justice field.
There's just so many different ways you can go in the law enforcement field depending on like what you want to do. If you want to become a detective, parole officer, probation.
Personally, my experience here greatly enhanced my knowledge out there on the field. The most rewarding thing to me is to know that I did the best job that I could for that day.
The normal person goes away from a burning building, whereas, you know, we're having to go into or up to a burning building.
It basically prepares you from the very, very basics to, you know, to where you're able to perform the job once you're out there.
It's a real good program. It'll teach you all the basics that you need to know to go out and start a job as a firefighter.
In order for you to be certified, you have to have your EMT basic. We learn how to work as a team, as though it's a team effort.
the specific procedures for lifting ladders and, you know, how to actually put on all of your equipment. We do live fire training while we're going through the program inside the controlled burden building over at the training academy. They do have the classes for fire and arson investigation.
I feel really comfortable with my job right now. I enjoyed it. It was an experience that I would not change for anything.
I was influenced very early on about welding. That's something I've always kind of wanted to do.
When I first came here, I was like, oh, metal, you know, just fuse it together. And now I'm using like different electrodes, different metals.
You need to learn how to weld in a straight line. You gotta have a steady hand. If you don't feel comfortable or you don't know what you're doing, then you can talk to your instructor.
You practice it and then you show them your practice. If they approve of the practice, you then go to your test plate.
The weld is very crucial. It has to be perfect. And if it's not perfect, then it's not going to test out.
With the degree program, you can do anything. You can do underwater welding and NASA welding, anything.
I like using my hands. I don't mind getting dirty. I mean, 100% hard work.
I love hands-on. Knowing that you've accomplished something, that you've built that with your own hands.
What they're giving, 'cause I'm working for a living. Hey, I'm not complaining, 'cause I really need to work. But hitting up my buddies got me feeling like a jerk. $100 condo, $200 rent. I get a check on Friday, but it's already spent.
Yeah, I used to love taking things apart. I like to know how things work, know really what's going on deep into the machine.
I like electronics. You'd be amazed with some of the components if you make them and you build them.
The program gives you a good basic of what you're going to encounter out on the field. Everything that you tell the machine what to do will do it in a time frame shorter, faster, and more accurate.
You need to know how to read schematics. You need to know math to make calculations.
Person that likes to mess with any type of machine, pneumatics, hydraulics, electronics, electrical, you'll be prepared for any kind of equipment you encounter.
With this kind of feel, I mean, you can find a job anywhere you like.
Tired of being out there and swinging the hammer. So, you know, what else could I do that I enjoy?
First semester, we did use the drafting tables, and it was definitely something great to learn, but now we're mostly on computers.
The whole purpose of that is for you to actually learn the principle of drafting.
In commercial, we did a health clinic, and now we're doing things outdoors, like designing stores, houses.
It's not just the drawing of the building, it's the plumbing, the electrical, the sewer. You have to be a critical thinker.
Problem solving. You have to go back and figure out what you did wrong.
Most of the instructors out here actually worked in the industry, so they were able to give us actual real life examples of what the employer is to expect out of you. Don't just walk away here with the knowledge of how to draw or how to do drafting, but you walk away knowing how to design. This program out here opens a lot of doors.
Science.
back there. And this is the yacht, and I'm just going to talk to you guys a little bit about it, about the things we've done to it. We've made a lot of improvements because we've hit a lot of bumps along the way. We've made it a lot smaller because last time, you know, it was really big and it was made out of PVC pipe. And this time we've made it out of steel, and we've got the gun to rotate so you can do it to where it's most convenient for you at any angle. And the gun itself is a lot stronger. It just makes it a lot easier for the can to be crushed itself. And basically, it's just we've made some improvements just to make it better. And Katie is going to demonstrate for you the can actually being crushed. All right, here's a demonstration of the can being crushed. And keep in mind that Katie is the one doing the can crushing, and she's pretty wimpy, so just remember that. Here we go. How's it feel, Katie?
Okay.
Just let me know when you're done.
That's good right there?
Yeah, looks good.
All right.
I like making things. I like seeing and experiencing what I make.
There's basically two major aspects to machining. There's computer machining and there's traditional machining. So they start us off on traditional lathes and mills. The more modern method is computer-based CNC machining. You start off modeling on the computers and then you move up to programming the machines and learning to operate the controls.
It helps to have some sort of a base background in mathematics.
You get to actually physically touch the things you're working on and see the results of your hard day's work. If you're proud of your work, it's really easy to put in the time and the dedication and the thought that it takes to get a really high quality product.
I think it's the knowledge that you get here that's going to help you in the industry.
I grew up in an agricultural area, working on the tractors, the trucks, whatever it took to get the job done. I'm gonna start from square one, take you up to a basic beginning knowledge of everything that entails to work on a truck, tractor, construction equipment, whatever it takes.
All the instructors here are very, very knowledgeable. When they take you through your basic instruction on everything, they're very thorough.
Most everything that they do, they're gonna have some type of lab or hands-on approach to doing everything. Here, the basics and the principles are being taught every time you touch something.
You have to have a basic understanding of what components there are on a vehicle, what components there are on an engine.
It's very hard to find that qualified and driven technician that you're looking for right now.
It really is going to improve my marketability when it comes time for me to graduate and go out there and try to start interviewing for jobs.
I fell in love with cars when I was about 13, and I knew that's what I wanted to do.
The things that we look for when we hire somebody is we'd like somebody with a degree, and that's basically so they can understand us.
You start out pretty basic, learning the shop, using tools and amenities inside it. We learn a lot of safety. There are first semester courses that do immediately get you touching engines. I kind of came in knowing that electronics were going to be a major part. I didn't know they were going to be this in-depth.
You have to be able to do mathematics in order to repair cars.
In the later classes of the program, you're assigned to look up articles to help you research new concepts, new ideas.
I take pride in repairing things that other people haven't been able to repair and having a person that's appreciative of what we've done for them.
Yeah, okay. Let's go. Yeah.